Something that we saw when we were looking at the split program before is that if we just combine the interesting values that we identify, we might end up with a lot of cases. And I mentioned that we're going to look at some way of addressing that problem. And this is exactly what happens in the next step of the category partition method, in which we identify constraints among choices. And why do we identify these constraints? We do that to eliminate meaningless combinations of inputs. If you remember, for example, we had the case in which we were trying to create a string with a size less than zero, which doesn't make any sense. And very importantly, we also do that to reduce the number of test cases, because every time we constrain one of the possible choices, we eliminate possible test cases. So we can use it to keep under control the number of tests that we generate. There are three types of properties: the pair property if, error properties, and properties of type single. So we're going to look at what these properties mean using once more our example of the split program. In particular, we're going to use some of the choices that we identified earlier. So let's look, for example, at choice 0 for category length of the string. What we can say is that if the length is 0, this defines a special property of the string, and we specified it in this way by saying that this identifies properties 0 value. So every time that we use this choice, 0 value is defined. At this point, we can use this to exclude some meaningless combinations. For instance, consider special characters. If we have a string of length 0, which means a string with no characters, obviously there cannot be special characters. So considering this combination will just be a waste of time. So what we do is that we specify next to this choice that we only consider this if length is not 0. And we do this by saying that we consider this only if not 0 value. So if 0 value is not defined. So this pair is an example of a property if case. Define a property and use that property. Now let's look at a case in which we might want to use an error property. For instance, when we look at the category value for the input size, the choice value less than 0 is an erroneous choice. So it's a choice that we selected to test a possibly erroneous situation. So we can mark this as an error property. And what that means is that when generating possible combination of choices, we will consider this only once, because we assume that we just want to test this error condition once. Finally, the single property is a property that we use when we want to limit the number of test cases. And it's similar as an effect to error. It just has a different meaning. So what we do when we use the single property is that we're saying this choice we want to use in only one combination. So don't combine it multiple times. And that, of course, given the combinatorial nature of the problem, cuts down dramatically the number of test cases. And we might use, for instance, the single property for maxInt, which means that we will only have one test case in which the size is equal to maxInt. We're actually going to see a demo on this topic, so we'll have more chances of seeing how properties work in practice and how good they are at eliminating meaningless combinations and at reducing the number of test cases.